to band. Dear liquids, turn me to band, turn to band.
I love the arcana on that graphic, the shimmery gold. Nature's Prophet. This is at the top.
There it is. Newbie first bands Nature's Prophet.
And Team Liquid doesn't even have to change a lot of their early bands. First band, Earth Spirit. We saw Kaka do unbelievable work with Earth Spirit. Well, actually, he always does. He's always incredible. And then, look at this. Nature's Prophet, Wisp, first band from Newbie. I think we're going to see Kyle out of Liquid.
It's hard to say. I think it's a big decision for them to ban this Nature's Prophet. I think it's the right call to make. To me, it says that they're probably going to stick with their Bloodseeker, because I think before playing against Nature's Prophet, they haven't really encountered anything that Bloodseeker couldn't lane against. So they start out with Lich. I guess it's sort of a deny pick as well. It's an open first pick, so pretty good for them to have their support shown only. I think it's weird to me if it's actually like this where Newbie had selection priority in first game and Liquid this game, then Newbie remaining. Took second pick first game and now they have first pick. So if that's the case, I assume that both teams prefer second pick.
Earth Shaker.
I mean, Team Liquid.
Venomance.
You know, these are their two winningest heroes. Just getting them right out of the way right now, you now know you're going to have a strong win with Venomancer.
I mean, that's a great thing about Liquid, in my opinion, because they have just so many things they can pull off the bag. Like, I personally think they are the hardest team to like craft against, because their hero pool is just like, they can play almost every single hero in the game, I feel like. And when you know, like, some team picks LC second, you know they're kind of lost. That's the case in Newbie right now.
That. Make it explicit for all the non-professional players out there.
I don't know. Craig, would you like to explain?
I mean, I think this Legion Commander hero is the hero that the Chinese team liked a lot. I think it's pretty exclusive with Lich. There might be something to it against Venomancer. It's a pretty okay lane matchup against Venom, so I'm guessing that's their idea. I think the good thing about Liquid's opener is that they have two heroes that they've played in multiple roles. They can enable each other in the way that Mind Control can play this Venomancer. Because GH plays Shaker, then he can block the offlane wave and then this Venno is enabled. So for Liquid, the difference between Liquid's first two in this game and Newbie's last game is that their draft is open. And I think if you want to, if I go from the assumption that they took second pick, this is what you need to abuse, because if you run into the second phase where you have to show your course, you're going to get counterpicked. But this way they kind of avoid it, so it's a good opener from Liquid.
We've been talking about all of these heroes that are good versus summons. Shaker, the one that Team Liquid have been going to. Legion Commander, actually not that bad of a matchup versus Nature's Prophet, but I think overall the playstyle from Nature's Prophet, too good in Liquid's hands. And yeah, it is one of the few heroes that can stand toe-to-toe versus Venno in lane.
You know who's really good against summons, Merlini? It's Winter Arvin.
Yeah. Can't argue with that.
The Newbie could have used it last game, to be honest. I was talking to Crit and he thought that was a real good pick there.
This isn't even for the memes, but I think when they picked Crystal Maiden, I was thinking to myself, this is where they should pick Winter Wyvern. And I know the hero hasn't had a lot of success, and I know there's a lot of memes about it.
It has not had success.
you have to look at the games, because one of the games we played against Liquid in the group stage, we were playing with Bad Rider and Winter Wyvern. And the Wyvern, the way it works against Liquid, especially against this Nature's Prophet, is that it gives you a support that can push out waves, and it's also a strong laner. Most supports can't really match up against Nature's Prophet on lanes, but what Wyvern does is that he moves between lanes instead. So I thought it was an interesting idea, but
yeah.
This game obviously no Nature's Prophet, so I doubt they will even be thinking about it.
You see the Morphling ban, and there was some intimidating Morphling play out of Miracle in this tournament, and, well, I guess, you know, fourth ban on the Coddle and on the Dazzle. This Dazzle ban is kind of interesting to me.
Dazzle is a straight-up counter to Legion Commander, because you want to duel and burst someone, but Dazzle just graves you. And so the entire duration of duel is a bit less than the Dazzle grave duration, so it's like a straight-up counter. And this feel like Liquid could probably use some lane pressure, and Dazzle is lane pressure, I think. It's not like they should ban it.
Now, Ancient Apparition is an interesting pick in Team Liquid's history because they have been first banning it most of the time in their lower bracket run back.
Yeah. I think the reason why Newbie banned these two heroes were because they know that Liquid have to pick a position 5 first thing in the next in this phase, because
five
they show
remaining.
They're gonna probably assume that this Shaker is gonna be GH, but they don't know if this Venom is gonna be like which core it's gonna be. They know it's gonna be a core, so Liquid basically have no reason to show a core on this third pick, and they decide to pick AA. It could have been Dazzle was probably the best option, and then I think they banned Coddle because of the comfort, and then I think AA is just as good as others, honestly, but. It's hard for Newbie to ban out all the good position 5s right now.
Now, in terms of those cores, what do you see coming forward down the line from Newbie? What types of cores are they going to be exploring?
Well, could be an AM game. You guys love AM versus Venom.
I think it's so far it's okay.
Yeah, but everyone on the team feels like that Shaker is a direct counter to AM.
Yeah.
And if you add AA with that, I think it's not the dream AM game.
But I think there's a difference between playing AM against the support Shaker and a mid lane Shaker. Because what we would like to do against AM if we had Venom and Shaker is that we would put Shaker mid, because the physical burst is really good against AM. So Newbie picked Sanking here, which is what they were probably supposed to do. They needed to pick some position 4 because they don't know the cores of Liquid
remaining.
Yet. And this is where Liquid, they kind of have to pick a core, commit
five
to something.
Remaining.
It could be...
Actually, I don't know if that's a really good thing.
I think what they are thinking is that they don't want this Venomancer to lane against Legion Commander. So most likely what's going to happen is that they're going to put this Venomancer mind control, put him off lane, and then this Necrolite's going to go safe lane against Legion, which is probably a lane that they think is good. I'm not sure how it goes with Lich on the lane as well. Could be a bit hard.
So we have some nice ability to catch with Sand King's stun, Legion Commander's ultimate duel.
I think from what I've seen from Liquid, actually, they played yesterday, they banned AA twice. That was against LGD, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure. I think it was LGD. But they banned AA twice in the first phase. And both those games, they went for some heroes that are like countered by AA. They went for Necrophos in one game, and the other game, they went for Husker, I think. So they so this game they picked AA and they picked the Necrophos, so they're abusing that this hero is not available for Newbie.
Newbie picks Quaff.
10 seconds.
I don't know. It does not look like a very good Quaff.
No, but I think the reason why they pick Quaff here is because they have to pick
to
their
bad.
Mid hero before Liquid shows theirs. And I think they're scared of picking them, like getting a bad matchup mid. But when you have Queen of Pain, the chances of you having a good matchup is pretty high. And they had to pick it before Liquid anyway. So basically, they know that Liquid's last hero is going to be a miracle hero that's going to go mid.
10 seconds remaining.
I guess it's one of the finest heroes to put mid against Liquid.
Five
they like
seconds
to rotate
remaining.
Yeah, they like to play around mid, so it's good to have a mobile hero there.
Last ban is Weaver for Team Liquid. Still no fifth ban from Newbie. And we've seen Team Liquid do really powerful last picks. Are there any big standouts for Team Liquid that you think are significant threats Newbie needs to look out for?
I think Miracle might just go and be like, pick me in mid.
Yeah, I could see that happen. I think this is the hardest part when you play against Liquid and they have last pick, is that they have a lot of options on that pick. They can play like most mid heroes mid, and they can play a lot of safe laners mid as well. So it's really hard to predict what they want to go for. I think Newbie just have to take like, just think of the worst hero for them. Like, what's the worst hero that Liquid could pick, and they just have to ban it, even if they don't think it's that possible, because it's going to happen. Liquid know what heroes are good for the game.
What are some of those worst heroes?
It's hard to say this game. I think if you play against this team, I would probably say Anti-Mage, because it's a comfort hero for them, and they have the heroes that can create space for him. It's a decent thing against Quap, so
you
I think maybe Anti-Mage. They ban Lycan. Not sure why they would ban Lycan.
Yeah. Looks like a really
worse than Anti-Mage. It's a good Anti-Mage game. I think it makes perfect sense for them because they know the Shaker is going to be supported, and they see Necrophos and Venomancer, two cores that are not very good against Anti-Mage.
Yeah, once mid-game kicks in, Lich, Legion Commander, Sand King, and Queen of Pain can do all sorts of attempts at ganking,
remaining.
Bombing in, trying to get pickoffs, while Anti-Mage sits back and comfortably farms.
Yeah, one thing Newbie changed this game is that they have a lot of lane pressure.
Select your heroes.
Alright.
We have seen Team Liquid in this situation before. Their Alchemist against an Anti-Mage. We've also seen Team Liquid in their last two games put up dominating performances in the first 5 minutes. And the question on everyone's mind is, can Newbie pull it together and succeed in game 2? Let's find out. Take it away, Toby.
You know, where no team has ever lost the winner's bracket quarterfinal, made the lower bracket run and won a grand final at TI. No player has won TI multiple times, and no brand has actually won TI multiple times. We get to scratch a couple of these things off at the end of this grand final, but who will it be? This draft looks a lot more balanced to at least give us a good contest.
Yeah, I think Newbie made the necessary adjustments based on game number one. I like, as much as the panel were uncertain about this Legion commander pick, I like the idea of just having something stronger in lane. They have Lich and Legion as their first two picks. To me, that just screams out, okay, we got destroyed in lanes, we can't let it happen again. So
yep.
They've solved that. Now, Liquid are taking a bit of a slower approach in this game, a bit more greedy, which they also are very good at playing with this Necrophos and Alchemist. But Newbie, I think, made the right preparation into that last phase, getting the Anti-Mage pick that the panel thought would be great for Liquid. They steal it themselves and set themselves up for what I think could be a pretty good Newbie game. The challenge here is to shut down the Alchemist. Alchemist doesn't have a good game. I'm all Newbie on this one, but... do they have the right heroes for it? They at least have the Lich.
Yeah,
to start.
They had the Lich to at least balance out the lane, and maybe that's when we start to see the movement of Karga being one of the other critical points. You don't have that invis hero like we saw Bounty Hunter messing around with Alchemist in the previous matches in the playoff. So this time around, how much space do you get? How big does the Alchemist get? And how well can Newbie control it and potentially win this game too and force us into almost a best of three situation you can describe it as?
It's going to be really interesting to see what goes down here. Also, something that Newbie secured themselves in this game that they didn't have in the last game. I think when you have a player like STC, you want to make sure he gets a good start. I think they sacrificed him way too hard mid in the last game. Arguably, maybe they didn't even have a choice, but his lane just went way too bad, and this time they have given him a strong laner in the Queen of Pain, one of his absolute best.
The smoke. Korra puts down the Observer Ward. He'll actually break each other's smokes, and Karka wants to go on the run. It is a Boots first SK, and yeah, they do throw down the Sentry Ward, so they're going to give Queen of Pain the extra money and the vision advantage in mid. You wanted SCC to have a really fantastic lane in mid, now you've lost that Observer Ward that's meant to gain it, and the other Observer Ward's already been placed up on the northern side to save mind control on that offlane. And mind control's going to have a hard time against Moogie. Moogie's preparing himself for a lot of damage. PMS and four tankos is his way to start that top lane.
Yeah, this is, in my book, a very anti-mage favorite lane, when he has the safe lane and Vino's off lane. I don't think if this is even just a flat-out isolated one-on-one, Moogie will be able to take control of this lane fairly quickly. Now, something I would like to see Faith do in this game for Newbie is it looks like he's going to start dual off lane with Legion. In the past, we've seen something like Warlock Legion Commander lanes, Dazzle Legion be very powerful.
Mind control.
Let's go Blink and get out.
Actually, yeah, there's no Gale. I thought for a moment they might have committed that, but Mind Control, he's looking for the chip damage to start with.
That's decent, though. Even forcing him to skill Blink here is going to make Mind Control's laning situation a lot better, because AM wants to skill Mana Break and use that Sand King stun to pressure the Venomancer in lane. Now that Kuro is there and they have his dual lane set up, they'll be doing fine. So what I would like to see from Newbie is this Legion Commander will get some help in the bottom from Lich. I think Lich should double down on this mid. I think they should really try to destroy Alchemist as much as they can. And then if Legion suffers a bit against Necro, then so be it. I think Legion will actually be just fine in that matchup for quite a while. One of the more sustainable heroes. But they look to contest Matumba Man as their first priority so far.
Yep. This will also allow KP to ensure his farm on this bottom lane, maybe rushing that timing of the Blink Dagger so they can get the jump initiation control the Alchemist earlier on, because they don't have that straight up initiation just yet. GH has all the initiation he wants, especially
with
SCC. He doesn't actually have his Blink available, so runs around the corner, still a Shadow Strike available so he can actually do some return damage into GH if he likes. But he's got a creep wave coming, he wants to wait for it.
He wants to do the damage to Miracle. If he's spending mana in this lane, he wants it to go into that Alchemist.
Kaka, oh, they're body blocking Kuro. Moogie blinked in front of him, so the blink actually works to get close towards Kuro. Now he has level 2, so mana breaks available. Kuro's on the run, wants to try and juke in the fog before it won't be successful. Newbie, this time around, they'll be the ones to spill first blood, and it goes to an anti-mage.
Very good start for the AM in that regard. Has zero CS, however. Still not a single creep being brought down by Moogie. That's the benefit of this aggressive dual lane that Liquid ended up putting. Kuro will die, but... so far, so good still for Liquid's gameplay, I feel. The Alchemist is having a good start in the mid lane, and
bottom.
Apart from Kuro's death, they're just fine.
Matumba, Faith wants to block him. You got the Frost Blast off cooldown right now. Matumba can't make its way back through the tree line. KP, he actually blocked it perfectly, and Newbie. They get another kill on the opposite lane core.
I wonder if Matumba could have survived that if he used his wand and his fairy fire. Maybe could have gone into the trees and solved up, but...
way he was going to survive that at all. And will be killed off. So let's see what the Lich does now. I'm still have my eyes on Faith. It tells a lot about Yuffie's approach to the game, which lane they send this Lich to. GH will steal the Bounty Rune, one of the benefits of Shaker, this ability to block off mid lane.
Baragult. Alright, very, very dead. Taka was rotating in, but 2 points up in the Shadow Strike with no regeneration for an Alchemist, and that 3 armor points, and not enough to actually stop the Queen of Pain from finding the kill. I think for the first time in this series, the China crowd have finally gotten a voice.
Yeah, they get a bit to cheer for here as SCC gets to play Dota. It's gotta feel nice, you know? Last game he couldn't really do much on his Lina, got shut down very hard. This time around, he is on the dominating side. Full level ahead now with Queen of Pain against Alchemist.
Matumba taking
a hard time.
Matumba taking a hell of a lot of damage on bottom. Frost Blast plus the level 2 up in the overwhelming odds. And KP's happy to keep aggressive with that Frost Armor on him. GH and Matumba can't really turn around a fight. But I am really just wondering, how long do you keep Faith here? How long until you bring him up to the top lane and relieve this pressure which is so heavily on the anti-mage?
I think AM can fend for himself when he gets a Quelling Blade. But Mugi was forced to buy this Ring of Health first so he can even sustain. He will be losing CS for a while yet, but the Anti-Mage versus Venomancer matchup is not too bad. We could see Mugi take a page out of Burning's book and maybe get multiple points in Spell Shield, something we've seen Burning do before. Widely considered the most influential Anti-Mage player of all time, so...
Yep. See, and he'll need it against this toxic offlane of Mind Control, and there's double the toxicity. You're running both all the Venom plus the Poison Sting on Mind Control.
He is going to level up Mana Break though, so still holding on to the more aggressive approach, where if Kaka comes in and has a bit more health than this, maybe they can turn it into a play now. Top rune?
Yeah, the Curry is coming. Okay, well, Kaka, that's a little bit mean. SCCC could have, in fact, bottled up completely and then grabbed the Invis rune.
Well, you know, it's a lot of time to wait. I think they were worried that the rune was going to get contested. Kaka also gets his Tranquils from the Courier, so he will get full health anyway, and can look to make a move. So Miracle is done with mid. He's just done. And going to retreat into that jungle. There's a
well, what a perfect time to have an Invis rune.
Yeah,
if Miracle's going to go jungle, Kaka could just walk up behind him. Miracle is bottling up, but he's still going to take considerable damage. It's a level 2 Pharah strike. There is no Sandstorm, so Kaka will have to rely on just his normal damage. He can leech in the meantime. And if Miracle does the math, maybe he can work out that an SK is on top of him. Kaka. Tony, it's looking for Curry for a second. He'll wait the party. SCCC! He was moving off the mid lane, no warning bells flagging up for Miracle, and the Alchemist dies while farming.
SC was just waiting to get that level 6 so he could come down for the Sonic. Getting another big kill, so much, much better start this time around for Newbie.
This is the advantage though for Kuro. He's able to get rid of that Observer Ward nice and early on. So Alchemist cannot be watched as closely as he was previously. He's already gone off the other plane anyway.
So look at what Liquid have done to adjust. I don't know if this is the right approach. They've sent Matumba Man into mid because he was struggling bottom and they want the Alchemist to jungle. So this is the lane with the most experience. They want to have 4 there, but this Necro is level 4 and he's going to lean against an almost level 7 Queen of Pain in an already Queen favorite matchup. This is almost impossible. Any rotation in from these supports on the Dire will either kill Matumba or send him back to base. He needs to be very careful with how he plays this lane matchup, as KP is just, you know, fine with facing anyone bottom. He's Legion Commander. It's a great lane no matter what.
You'll send in another Shaker in here. Okay, yeah, he's going to beat into Faith. Kaka wants to help him out, but here comes Mugi. Burn him off. They deny him up as well. Mind Control can't even find that kill with all of his friendly Plague Wards around him. They cannot save his life.
All right, Yubi woke up, man. This is something else.
This feels like the shoes on the other foot.
Yeah.
Team Liquid were doing this to Newbie in game 1. Now game 2 comes around and everything is going up Newbie. And KP's looking for that level 6. And this is why GH is so scared. He doesn't know when KP's going to crack that level 6 and duel becomes available. Then the Earthshake is gone.
Now the challenge for Newbie in this game is to do something similar to what Liquid did in the last, which is win the lanes and then keep the pressure on. You need to keep finding kills. Since Liquid losing the lanes is okay in this game to an extent, because their Alchemist, if he is farming, can overtake the game. But it's going to be a while before that's a possibility, and Newbie will want to get into this Radiant jungle, prevent
it
from stacking
top.
And farming.
The smoke gang. Mind Control's dead. He has no way to get back off this top lane. Burrow Strike, a level 1 Ice Blast, and Mookie blinks forward, but the Burrow Strike holds Mind Control in position. He'll get a Gale onto Tootsam, some damage back in return, but Mookie kill secures with the map. They were waiting on bottom, moving the Ancient Apparition down south to help out the Earthshaker in preparation for KP's attack, but it never came.
In the meantime, the Alchemist is still bombing. This is the hero to look out for. I say this.
Wait, does SC kill mid? He's got Blink and Sonic Wave available, and Metalman's got 350 HP.
If he knew he was here, he would just go for it. Oh, okay. That's a lot of
okay. Yeah, sorry. I forgot it's a Necro, mid.
First round, 17 stick.
Oh, but still! SC didn't
Who
bring
cares,
anything!
Man?
He did the math he was looking at. It's like, yep, heal down. Nuke up.
Yep, that's that matchup for you. Queen of Pain is 3 levels above him. Metalman heals up to full and dies from full. So. Well, what are you going to do? Miracle is still farming, and this is an Alchemist game. Alchemist is the centerpiece of the draft. He's picked last. They're trying to set up to give him a good game. He is the hero to look out for.
He still is top net worth of 4,400, 4,500, but Kaka and Faith looking to change around the bounce a little bit more, rotating down towards the bottom lane. Don't have the vision on G8, the tree line making it troublesome. But Tarman also rotating over, only a couple of points away from having that level 6. Wants the ultimate, but thanks to press the attack from Kaka, from KP, Kaka can back off. And they're actually bringing SCCC down to the bottom lane. Picking up an illusion rune. Okay, no, he's just coming for the rune only. No one's defending mid. They understand Liquid have numbers somewhere. They want to see where they are first.
It's a really good point, though, that there's no bounty hunter in this game. I think that was a very clever pick in that series. Was that the lower bracket semis, I think? In which a team playing against Alchemist, it was LGD who ran the bounty hunter and Ursa. So they countered the Alchemist in lane, and then they countered him in game plan as well. And I'm not seeing the exact same thing out from the newbie side. They have the Anti-Mage who will like to farm just like Alchemist will, and generally that gives Alchemist more space because that fifth hero can't really join. But they don't have like the scout, so they want to send in heroes to at least get wards out, and that's exactly what Kaka and Faith are doing right now.
They found their target. There's no level 6 on the Lich. The Courier's gonna come
up. Oh my god!
And the Courier might save it. Faith's attack will follow through. The Courier lives on 12 HP. He is actually the one thing that Liquid has that can potentially survive on this map. SC wants to have another crack at Miracle. Chemical Rage will wear off in a second. And Kaka and Faith, well, if you can't kill Couriers, try the Alchemist. That's a good option. Baron Strike forward. SCCC, he does have the Sonic Wave available. Another Shadow Strike. Miracle's Chemical Rage is gone. But with the armlet up, they're not taking the chance here. Maybe they want to keep pressuring the towers and gaining control of this map.
He's a very difficult kill now. The fact that he got to this armlet sub 10 is good and very important for Liquid. That's still the one thing they really are holding on to in this game, as their other cores are not having that great of a time. Mind Control has recovered fairly nicely, went for the phase boots in that top lane and max plague wards, but at the same time, that also means his mana sustain is pretty weak. He's actually running out of mana now and has to go back toward his shrine. Well, actually, just plays a defensive plague, gets some nice info out. Miracle doesn't care, he's gonna run in.
Yeah, he's fine.
Get off my lawn, man. This is my jungle. This is the area Alchemist wants, but it's warded up very nicely.
Yep. Yeah, newbie watch to the north as well as to the south, but the funny thing is that there's tools to also...
Oh, SC? You got a haste. It's not easy being AA when there's a hasted level 10 core coming at
you. It's a little easier when you got the observer ward down, so SCC thinks he can go on mid. GH in the neighborhood has Echo Slam available. Wants the creep wave to beat there, however, now he'll run out. Vision to start with Echo Slam! Oh. The damage! Ripples out to the Queen of Pain, but the stun does not.
Just barely out of range of that aftershock. The 300 radius, I think we're talking 10s there for SC. But far enough away for that not to connect. I wonder if it would have even been a kill. Miracle didn't have concoction skill, so I don't know if the pull-up would have been enough. But
you do have that plus 10 on strength on SCPC.
Yeah, it's the standard pop skill to take on level 10. It's very powerful. This hero, one of its weaknesses is the low health pool that it has. It wants to itemize mostly items that don't give that much health in the beginning of the game. So the fact that you can skill this 10 HP, 10 strength talent has helped Queen of Pain a lot in terms of becoming a top-tier pick.
Kuro is looking for this observer ward, but again, a lot of variation in the observer wards coming out. This time is from Nubi. They're a little bit further down, so Nubi can still watch when Team Liquid move further east inside their own jungle. In fact, now realizing that there's only Metalman on the bottom, KP has Blink Dagger up. He wants to go for a quick jump. Needs the vision on Metalman. Their observer wards don't exactly see that. And in fact, the observer ward from Liquid sees the fact that Faith and SCCC have come to the bottom lane, and Metalman hides behind the T1 tower.
Liquid are just going to split pressure this map right now with the Venomancer top and two additional heroes connecting there. So probably going to see a tower trade. Maybe playing in the Radiant Jungle. Alchemist is pretty far away from them, so they won't find him. They were probably hoping to do that.
I feel like we forgot about mind control. He's just been sitting up on the top lane, fighting whatever farm he possibly can. His net worth's not really reflecting it, but now getting a lot of damage into the T1 tower on top. This is a good injection of money for Team Liquid. Two T1 towers have fallen. Ancient Apparition denied to mid, but mind control does get the last hit on the top lane. SCCC will try and even the odds by taking the bottom one.
This is the, in a way, the only way Liquid can play this game right now, is to use this Venomancer to try to knock down towers and pressure out lanes, because their other heroes are really weak at putting pressure on structures. Alchemist needs to farm, the AA is level 5 and can't really do much. Necropost got shut down in lane, so, and then you have a support Shaker who has to stand in the backline, so who is actually going to prevent Yubi from just playing their game? It has to be mind control, he has to play aggressive like this. He might die once or twice, but somebody's got to do it for Miracle.
Newbie's coming in force. Miracle's going to keep his farm going. The Observer Ward is there. Might give a little bit of extra confidence now. SCCC, he actually has his smoke broken by Metumberman as they go over the Observer Ward. This may be the best thing Liquid could have seen. Microtrol starting his TP. Kuro will be the sacrificial lamb. And GH as well. The Fissure creating a little bit of extra space. Starts his TP, but KP has the tool available. Kaka, Boris Strike brings the damage up, allowing KP to get the win. Plus 10 damage into the Legion Commander, but your two supports die for what could have been a hell of a lot worse fight for Team Liquid.
It's space. I think they reacted very well to this smoke gank from Newbie. They saw it coming, they dodged in the correct directions, but realistically they will lose two heroes there, and it's the two lowest net worth heroes that they lose, so good job from them dodging. I mean, they didn't really dodge the bullet, but in a sense they did. Alchemist is still farming, but so is Anti-Mage. Anti-Mage had a hard start. 14-minute battle fury coming in here for Moogie. Skip the treads straight into BF. Wants to try to keep up with Alchemist's farm.
You know, it's a fun game too when the crowd is actually applauding a battle fury being picked up on the Anti-Mage. Also, Miracle. Just
welcome to the new age of Dota.
Just continuously farming up too. I don't know if this is like a lack of confidence or if he just wants it on him, but he bought the Radiance recipe before he bought the Sacred Relic.
It might be some reliable versus unreliable gold thing. Ha, like 120 reliable gold. Yeah,
you guys are nowhere. Scythe up on top, GH of damage. It isn't enough to get the Scythe kill on the Anti-Mage, but the kill does happen nonetheless.
And the kill goes to GH, so he's closing in on his Blink Dagger. I think that was the best hero they could get the kill on, better than the Necro. Necro will have an easier time finding the gold he needs, but this will be, for GH, a relatively slow Blink Dagger, since most of the time when he's Shaker, he's on the pressuring team, but in this game he couldn't really find many openings. It's his first kill, very unusual for them, 15 minutes in.
Just smart maneuvering from Newbie. And they keep that pressure up, at least inside the Radiant Jungle. KP is farming the close camps, which the Alchemists would love to farm. They're normally the safest on the Radiant side because they need both the Tier 1 and the Tier 2 tower. In fact, the Tier 1's already gone, and SCCC is running patrol around that tower area. It is not where Liquid want to go. Even Mind Control's force doing ancient farming slash stacking while Faith. He's standing by himself in the bottom lane, getting all the farm and experience he wants. This is just Newbie owning the map, and now they go for Blob. The ice will have to be nice. The kill already happens, a Miracle will fall. They need a little bit more damage into KP. Neither the Quomp or the Legion will shatter to that Ice Blast.
GH was not there. That Newbie saw a moment of opportunity and just pounced on it right away. If the Shaker's there with a defensive Fissure, who knows how that would have gone. But Newbie take all the opportunities. It's still, it's a 1k gold lead with a 10k, with a 10 kill advantage, but it's, that's Alchemist. If you're ahead against Alchemist in 16 like this, you're doing pretty well. And Newbie are in a great position in this game so far.
I still wait to see just how well this Team Liquid defense can work. Because if it works nicely, if GH can finally get that Blink Dagger, like they're looking towards KP, Reaper Scythe is available, Ice Blast is on the way, they just have to hold him there, Vision to make sure of that, KP press the attack, the Scythe is down, not getting the perfect chaining of stuns, but the damage output will allow them to shatter KP on the top. But while this goes on, Newbie pressuring that bottom tier 2 tower, Catapult is there, but so is Mind Control, hiding behind the tower, starting his defensive play chords.
Yep.
He's almost got Yule Scepter too, and this is going to come up at the same time as the Orchid. Well, the Orchid's already done on the Queen of Pain. At least it's something where Microcarbon has to counter, but jump in, you're going to use it once. And Venomancer will fall, and the Tier 2 tower with him.
So I like this Yule's pickup quite a bit. I think it's nicely multi-purpose in this game. When you get Yule's, you generally don't want to have it only for defensive or only for offensive purposes. It's nice when it feels like use it very well for both. Offensively, he can try to counter out the Legion in the duel. He can use it to remove the Orchid defensively against the Queen of Pain. And it gives him, obviously, a way of setting up his team, that this Liquid team actually has very little cash. So even using it to set up a Fissure can prove to be very useful in later situations in the game. Also a nice mana region, you know. Then Venom won't have mana problems for the rest of the game.
Sure. 17 minutes is how long it took for the Alchemist to pick up the Radiance.
That's really
along
slow.
Along with the Omelette.
By Miracle standards. The three deaths and the shutdown of the map. He didn't get to free farm. Worth noting still is he's the only one having a good time. Everyone else is clearly behind par of what they would like.
They just need space, but they're also fearful to be anywhere on the map. Mind Control just run into mid, threw out the Venomous Gale and put down the Plague Ward, but he's not staying close enough for the experience, something you want to do as a Venomancer, especially when you have that plus 30% experience gain. You need those levels, they're going to need those big wards up.
It's going to be a while.
It will be.
If he gets to level 25, that's a first good step, I guess.
I'm wondering if he even thinks about going, because he already picked up the Yule Scepter, so there's a counter to the Silence, which is out, but... Do you go for what we've seen a couple of Venomancers do, but I think it's been mainly their first item, the Hand of Midas build for a Venomancer?
I think he needs Force Staff. They need some sort of mobility to utilize their other heroes. They can't move their heroes around in the fight. They're going to get caught by these either multi-hero stuns or all this AoE magic burst.
This is really patient. The Blink Dagger is up on the Urshaker. Karka is underneath a Radiant Observer Ward. They understand Team Liquid, and Matumbum is playing it so damn cool. He's not attacking. He's waiting for them to get in range. And now, Fissure jump up with the Ice Blast. They'll punish the SK, who all he was doing was being a farm boyer.
He died.
Yeah,
that was a big commitment. There was a smoke as well. So smoke kill onto support is generally not the best, but... It's something for Liquid defense, and I think there was a bit of two things. First of all, they were just being patient so they could set up a kill, but they had plenty of time to do that. They were trying to get a good read on the map. Did he have anyone behind him? Because else why would he sit there? And they had a lot of time to think it over.
They're backing up to smoke. So they're backed up a decent ways away from any Dire Vision. In fact, right now, Dire Vision is, well, non-existent. I'm looking for an Observe Ward on the map for the Dire, and it just doesn't exist. So, Newbie completely blind on the map, at the same time that Liquid want to fight. With Radiance and Armored up, Alchemist has Chemical Rage in 4 seconds, they want to get into battle. You've got Yule Scepter for control, you've got Blink Dagger and Echo Slam also available. Karka, is it going to be him once again? Blink in from G8, they'll keep the chains on going, actually committing the Echo Slam, and they'll fight them down. 30 seconds to the sideline for the SK, while KB hiding in the trees. Vortex trying to get vision, he'll blink further up into the trees. Mind Control is a Plague Ward to throw, but they need that little bit further to the right vision.
And they don't have it. Still got the tower there.
Wait, are they going up?
No. Aggressive move.
No.
Ill-advised.
Yeah. Animage is still farming up inside the Radiant jungle. And Team Liquid, they can at least leave the pressure up so Alchemist continue to farm for the Dire jungle, but... The teams have basically switched neutral camps.
We'll take that.
Miracle created a bit more of a gap there with this play, getting that tower, getting the assist gold. Now he's going to almost have his Mantis style. Well, speaking of which, Moogie has his in about 200 gold in anti-mage, so big items coming out, but he'll be overtaking him. I guess AM will be overtaking him if they get one gank on the Alchemist. These Alchemist kills are really important right now, and they might try to use the Mantis style for it. But if the game is played at this current pace and very slow, Miracle will keep building a further and bigger gap for this anti-mage to try to catch up to. He's currently sitting at bottom. The rest of his team is posing up top. Look at G8, actually just going into the vision.
That's confidence.
Well, that was close.
That's a lot of confidence. Can't creep and Barrow strikes. Kuro gets the second TP back out to base. So G8 to Kuro. Escaping from the lane.
He more or less blink dodged a melee Scream of Pain, or a short range Scream of Pain. So very close to connecting. If it connects, he's 100% dead. But it wasn't Kaka that found him. It was the Queen of any instant damage to prevent that blink. So he gets out. And again, space is the name of the game for Liquid. Keep buying time. And for the first time in this game, we might actually see Liquid get ahead on gold in a moment.
It's definitely getting closer. It's sub 1k. The difference between Liquid as well as Newbie. The experience graph, however, is a very different story. Sitting around 7,000 in favor of Newbie, just getting more across the map. Because Anti-Mage loves this. He's still got his mana style. He's good for, not great to fights, he's just good for fights, but good for the push game too. So both Mantas on the one positions.
Mugi went for the attack speed talent on Anti-Mage. I mean, I might be wrong on this, but I think almost everyone takes the Blink cooldown to have to quicker be able to traverse the map and get more farm, to have more chances of jumping in and out of fights. But it takes 20 attack speed, which is a fairly insignificant amount on a hero that already hits that fast. Might feel like that little bit of extra.
Knock up, gotta get out of there. Storm, Fisher coming in, and he's able to power a strike up. The Scythe will connect. KP breaking him free with the press, the attack. There's still a lot of tick damage on him. KP, maybe it's time to turn and deny him, or you could just let him die.
He can't deny me.
You're right, you can't.
No KO. They had the other two spells on him, though.
He actually hurts himself by pressing attack again.
Yeah, if the Gale was on him, then you're right. Then he might have died out. Oh, there goes the bottom tower.
Oh look, Alchemist.
Can you press off Gale? Gale is a special spell, man. Gale is weird. It has like its own subset of rules for how it works. I'm not sure. I don't remember honestly.
We can check later and learn Dota.
Yeah. You can probably press off Gale, but can't be beat off. So hard purge works.
Meanwhile, back at the farm game, Mugi's gonna head north. So moving as far away from the rest of Team Liquid as possible, exactly what the end mage has to do until he feels really ready to fight. At the same time, Miracle, we talk about those early towers going down, item progression, he's looking off green to come up next. It doesn't really feel too like Team Liquid are gonna have a bad time with Miracle getting more and more farm. Almost every single hero has a very good Aghanim Scepter on the Team Liquid lineup. So
their
the longer
lineup
this game goes, they love it.
Surely scale. Both Necro and Benno are great late game heroes in their own right. Now
that's
a dead Benno.
The duel onto him. Sonic Wave kicks. It connects down to Koro. The Lich Chain Frostbone bouncing down towards Matumba, but the Epicenter from Target not really close enough. And Matumba actually gets a TP out. They look for a different target, and it's GH on the other side of the trees. Three quick pickoffs. Legion Commander does dive for the cause, but potentially opens up Roshan.
I'm thinking about it against the plate. So annoying.
I was wondering if he would do this too. You talk about the attack speed. He's going to fuse a blade as his next core item.
This is a build we've seen sometimes on AM. In this game, it's great strictly because of the Necropulse. You want to purge off that Ghost Shroud. It's AM's shortcut to just hard countering that hero. We're going to see the smoke here. So it breaks instant duel coming out from the Legion Commander connecting with Queen. Rogue actually just died to collateral damage. It wasn't even the primary target, just got hit by everything on the way there. And picks for Nubi, losing their Legion.
Yep. Good picks for Nubi, keeping their lead, still 15-6. Of course, the kill count is that point when you understand that kills don't mean everything in Dota. Yeah, Nubi had the kill count 425 minutes in, but it's the gold advantage, which they are barely holding on to, and Liquid going in for Roshan.
This is a big moment. There is no Sonic Wave and no Chain Cross. Chain Cross actually. And no Epicenter. So Liquid, with that last 3-1 fight, the three big ultimates were expended.
So they just not fight then? Or is it... They have to pressure this somehow, even if it's just overwhelming odds. The Plague Wards are causing issues. There's two of them on the high ground. And thanks to the Observe Ward that's also planned, the Kaka's getting rid of. They see a lot. Kaka can't blink in. He cannot do that disengage. So he has to jump inside the sandstorm. Blink will come off cooldown. Roshan's pretty low. There's a jump forward. It goes into the Dirt Shaker. Aegis Immortal already has a Miracle and Liquid. Now they have everything they need to win this fight. The Ice Blast knocks the SK. Even the Scythe. 3 heroes for Nubi are falling down. GH gets the Echo Slam off. But Nubi, now it's time to fight with their cores, or is it? Mugi backs out towards the trine. SCCC can't kill off Koro. That one tree blocking the vision for him. He'll blink up and away. And the denial is there from Mind Control. The Shadow Strike being on him, not gonna do the work. Mugi can't get that kill. The one charges, giving the mana back to Matumbaman.
Was that even close?
I am not so.
Was he close to killing him with that Mana Void, and then suddenly Matu has 1500 health? I don't think Necro is that broken.
So here's the jump. Surprising Kaka didn't even go directly into the pit. He said he tries to hold back GH.
He couldn't blink. He kept getting cancelled by these Plague Wards from the high ground from Liquid, and they are so good when you're taking Roshan, the Plague Ward advantage. They're really helping out Liquid and securing this great play of the game. I think now they're kind of in the driver's seat. They have the Octarine Core and Aegis now on Miracle and could start looking to siege some buildings if they want to, or keep building up farm, getting some more key items. There's a big item currently flying out to Matumba Man. He's going to get that Blink again that he can also put on the Alchemist if he wants to. But Liquid, like you said, maybe they don't even have to try to win with this Alchemist so fast. Like, some games it feels like, okay, if Alk doesn't win, eventually the enemy team will overtake him with good late game carries, but not so sure in this one. So many good Axe heroes. All of the Liquid lineup uses Axe. The Shaker one is kind of funny more than anything, but the other heroes, it's very powerful on.
Also to note too, the maybe the mindset and tempo change up. Matumberman originally even bought the entire Dagon and then sold it to then move back into the Lincoln. So they understand you just survive early on. They make life difficult for Newbie to get initiated. That's what the Lincoln Sphere is capable of doing.
And Anti-Mage did this.
Yep.
So
Anti-Mage went in the Lincoln Sphere. Decided to go that and have the regeneration over having something more like the Aghanim Scepter we've seen on Anti-Mages, which has both the Lincolns and the Lotus Orb effect tied into it.
Actually, I think Axe would have been really nice this game because of the two spells he can reflect being really high impact. Reflecting the Scythe or reflecting the Concoction would have both been really good. Like, Elphos would be reflecting like Cold Feet, that's also nice. Threaten the AA, force him to move away. Realistically, AA will not really be casting it on him, so, you know, I think most of the time I'm a fan of the Lincolns pickup just because the stats are better for gold, but this game, the Axe is actually
Team Liquid are going to form up on bottom lane, five heroes together, bearing down the tier 2 tower, and Nubia are in no position to fight this. They're still trying to push out the side lanes. Nugi and Kaka taking care of the top, so it will be a straight tier 2 tower with the Octarine Core onto Miracle. Our cooldowns, wonderful regeneration, not just from the chemical raid, but also from a magical burn. If we're getting an Assault Cuirass next, he may even be looking at the tier 3 tower next. They're coming in now. Nugi, he has the TP ready. Kaka, ready to TP back as well. Blink King finds the Pyro Strike. He can get the Archivist. Mandy Dodge was attended. But while that Aegis Immortal is on the Archivist, Miracle will stand just chipping away at the tier 3 tower.
Oh, Blink King!
Blink and Spear actually triggered off the back of the duel. The Scythe is the return punishment for KT, misdemeanor.
Oh, he didn't see that Matumaman has the Lincolns. That's such a big mistake. No buyback. One minute. This is going to be Rackstone. They can't kill this Alchemist twice with these heroes now.
Yeah, is looking at
mail.
Kaka needs to bring in the Epicenter. They need the damage. Here comes the Epicenter from Kaka. Away from the wall. He's able to get the Fire Strike in. Necro, the Sonic Wave will kill it. Where is this damage? However, the Echo Slam from GH. Kaka holding down the Anti-Mage. Boogie's in trouble. The Blink up, but the Plague Force were there. Koro's the man that shatters him out. But that Ice Blast connects. It's just too much damage being done. You still have the AGC
Thunderbolt
there, as now, well, Miracle cancels himself, but GH, oh, the silence! SCCC controls him perfectly. Now the AGC Mortal is going to burn. Can they hold him there? Miracle back into the chemical rage. Manta is up, beating into the range right, turns attention over towards Moogie. He's already ready, he's burning down the rest of the newbie heroes. All he has to do is stand there if he's winning the game. Bringing down the creep wave, now it's the melee rack. Cross Armor is making this difficult, but not impossible. Team Liquid, where's that Burrow Strike? Coming in from Kaka, SCCC is back, he has that Orphan available. He waited for the Mana Star, but the damage is done. Miracle claims the melee ranks. They need something in return. The Lincoln Sphere triggers once again. Is Moogie moving forward? KP has the duel available, looking for the target. Miracle is low, can he get the duel off? Look for a different target. Microtron over the side, and they will find this pickup. SC and Moogie together, KP still wants the bloody duel, but what can he get? Microtron, there's your duel. Victory comes in. The side doesn't do enough. The Tumberman looking for another opening. He just walks around inside the shroud. They'll all blink away. Newbie, this has been a very expensive defense, and they still lost their bottom lane of Brax.
And who did they buy back? Anti-Mage only, I think.
It was Anti-Mage, Lich, and Sand King. They
had three buybacks
from
Newbie. I could not keep track of that. I was just laughing because Miracle was in the middle of everything. Lich is just attacking him for like 20 damage and dying to the Radiance and Acid Spray, and then Miracle in the middle of the fight, he has the presence of mind to just say Etaki again in team chat. Why is being hit by three? Oh man. Can you care any less than that, man?
It's a positive mood in the Team Liquid camp. We'll have a quick look at the fight once more. That's the critical moment. The Lincolns trigger, but Tumberman is safe, and the Legion Commander just cannot get what she wanted.
So full lane of Rax, three buybacks, and all they lost was Alchemist, Venno, and was that it? Did they even get any additional kills than that? Not sure.
That's a thing.
That's funny. Oh wait, we're playing for 10 mil.
There is a decent amount. A lot at stake. especially if Liquid can take this game, being two games up in the grand final. That is a horrible tunnel that Bubi will have to look down. The one when they walk off the stage knowing they're one loss away from losing that crown that all these players want so badly.
Yeah, Newbie's early game went very well this time as well. That's what they've got to be thinking about moving further. Win or lose this game, the early game went well. Right now it's not looking good, so again, what adjustments do you make at this point? The next one, do you try to... I think they will have pick priority in the next game, so maybe it wasn't that last pick from Liquid that was the really big problem, that they get this Alchemist. Could they have banned something different?
GH, there's so many picks. Stun on the Kaka, Fallstar gonna push him up. SCCC trying to create space for the Shiva's gun. And Miracle's gonna stun himself through the Lincoln's protection. That
no
Dagon is finally
that.
That Dagon is finally on top of it.
Level 1. A decent amount of burst with the Veil. And here we go again. So Liquid are not hesitating at all to put the pressure on.
This time there won't be the AGC Immortal, but he does have an Assault Cure on. Link Fire Strike. AKP. The duel is out. The duel is going to bounce around. Mind Control down, but comes back up again. The side. KP can't survive. He'll lose the duel. Miracle will come in with a plus 14 damage. Looking to try and end it. But Tomoko with a double kill. And Miracle remembers objective-based gaming. Buyback is there from SCCC, but losing two cores already. One of them forced to buy back on Newbie. Is already a huge victory for Team Liquid, but they're not done yet.
They're going to wait for Chemical Rage and push for the high ground again, knowing that TP cooldowns are now not available. There's no Chain Cross, no Blink Duel. And
look, he's going to try and run the back line. Blink Bar and Strike, holding Miracle into position. Venomancer almost down the Banner Boy. Boogie couldn't get it off down the exit from GH will control it. And this will be a huge kill if they can claim it. Heavy Mage is falling. Heavy Mage is down for 2 minutes. They've lost the numbers. There isn't enough defense here from Boogie. Without the enemy, that's a big call. They just don't have the damage. And GG, 34 minutes. Team Liquid, more than dominating. Ripping apart Newbie at the seams in game two.
It's been so beautiful to watch how Liquid were one game away from elimination and just slowly discovered what their strengths are as a team. Like, I think Liquid is the team in this main event with the most draft victories in this game. I didn't feel like they were clearly at an advantage, but they're building the advantages that they can in the given picks. And they have so many tricks and aces up their sleeve that they can use. And it just seems like these other teams like the tournament fail in comparison with what Hero Pools they have to pull out like this.
Didn't Samel say it perfectly on the panel, but Tumberman, this guy just has such depth. There's so many heroes.